So we've been calling your point of attraction. You getting a sense of it? You get what your point of attraction is? Your point of attraction is what you are offering vibrationally as you stand in your physical body right here, right now. And it's based upon what you're observing, what you're thinking about, what you're giving your attention to. And it doesn't matter if it's past, present, or future. It's what you're giving your attention to right here, right now, with your human body, with your human brain. And it is emphasized back to you by the emotions that you feel. Does that make sense to you? So here's this you standing right here. And here's this you standing right here. Here's this new and improved version of you, the furthermost expanded version of you. Here's who you really are. And then somewhere in relationship to who you really are is who you're being right here and now. And how you feel is the indicator of how you're being right here and now. How much of who you really are you letting flow to you and through you right now? In the conversation that you're having, who really is there? The whole version of you or the pinched off version of you? That I'm in love with life version of you? I'm in love with you version of you? Or the pinched off version of you? Who is flowing right here and now? Your emotions are your indicator of who it is. But we want to call your attention to something really important. You've got a point of attraction going on. You're choosing a grid. The grid, the framework that will fill in. The framework that is going to fill in with conversations, with ideas, with insights, with others, with interaction from others, with behavior from others. Everything that happens that has anything to do with you is your grid filling in. And every bit of your grid filling in is not about somebody else. It's about what you've been doing vibrationally with your grid. It's what you're doing right now with your grid. But what you're likely to do right now with your grid is more about what you've been doing with your grid. Do you get the grid? Do you know what the grid is? Do you understand the grid? Do you get the point of attraction? Do you get the grid? 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 You understand that you have a point of attraction. So do you understand that you have a point of attraction, and your point of attraction is a vibrational thing that's happening, and your vibrational thing that's happening has a relationship with this vibrational thing that's happening, this source energy part of you? Do you understand that? So do you understand that when the source within you is loving, loving at a capacity that we can't even find physical words to describe, and you aren't, you got a vibrational relationship problem. Do you sort of get that? But more important, do you understand that you can do something about it if you want to? That's really the point that we're wanting to make. Not only is that the point we're wanting to make, it's the point that we're wanting to really make. You are the creator of your own reality because you are the asker of the questions. You are the launcher of the rockets. You have an inner being who is the becomer of what you've asked for. And now, right here, right now, you are the chooser of the thought that lets you be all of that, or you are the chooser of the thought that doesn't. Period. So this point of attraction, picture a spinning grid. It's a grid, and it's spinning because it has momentum. And it has momentum because law of attraction abounds. So you choose a thought, and let's say it's not a very good feeling thought. Let's say it's a lousy feeling thought. But you chose it, and you have good reason to choose it because something happened that caused you to focus. And so you focused, and you chose it, and you focused upon it, and law of attraction settled in with you and gave you another thought like it, and another thought like it, and another thought like it, and another thought like it, till you've got a pretty good momentum going right here. Now, the source within you has this momentum going, but you've chosen this one. So you're not in the vicinity of who you are, but you're asking. In fact, you're asking with greater fervor than you've ever asked before, because this feels like a big problem to you. And so you're asking with an intensity, the likes of which you have never asked. And you know what happens when you ask with intensity? Source answers with intensity. So the water's being sucked from your pond. It's spinning in your vortex of creation. Source has added all of the power and energy that creates worlds and is flowing it back to you proportionately. And you're operating at 40 pounds of pressure because you've got a vibration going here, and the source within you has a vibration going here. So it just sucks, doesn't it? So it's time for more rules. Time for more control of the people around you. time for more wrestling them through the ground and killing them. Time for more explanation. Time for more making them understand your perspective. Not. All that does is keep the momentum going, doesn't it? All that does is increase more momentum. All that does is bring more like them to you. More who are on that vibrational disc. Because you know, Jerry used to say that he thought it would be really a nice thing if in the incarceration system in this nation, if there were islands of badness, and that all the rapers could live on an island and do it to each other, and all the murderers could live on an island and do it to each other, and all the thieves could live on an island, just take stuff back and forth from each other. He just thought it was the perfect plan. And we said, you already have those islands. The crowd didn't like that very much because they don't understand why the one who's murdered ends up on the same island with the murderer. Seems like there should be a little difference in the frequency. And we say, no. You pick these vibrations, you practice these vibrations, you make them your belief system, and then you pick these chronic vibrational spinning grid discs, and the momentum ensues, and then you always, for all of the days of your life, all day, every day, every waking moment, you have an emotional, meaning vibrational, relationship between what you're choosing here and now and that, and who you really are. So we've been calling this gathering for quite a long time, the art of allowing. The art of choosing a frequency, improving, until I'm in the vibrational place in my physical form of realizing, of allowing myself to realize the conversation, the idea, the manifestation, the actualization, the materialization, the confirmation, the affirmation of the power of your being, of the power of who you are, of the brilliance and worthiness of that which is you. Well, that's all we've got. And it's a lot. We're eager to talk with you about anything that matters to you. Nothing is off limits. Let's begin right here on the aisle.